Okay, friends, now let's go ahead with the next part of submitting. That is class B submitting. We saw class C, guys. I hope this was very simple to do. Now, the way we made a class table in class C, same way we make a table in class B also. And in class B also, guys, we have what? We have got a network portion, correct? This network, host, and host. Class C was quite similar as we had only one octet, correct? Of 8 bits. And in class B, there are 2 octets, guys. Can you see? There are 16 bits we have to play with. So we can borrow all the 16 bits, we can borrow all the 14 bits. Let's see how we can play with that of class B. So now, I ran the bit values over here. Bit number is 7 to 0, we got 8 number. Okay, bit number 8, 7, 6. Okay, I'll write it over here. Put one thing, guys. We are from 16 bit to first bit, like that. Okay, so see, first 2 octets are network. Then network, then bit number 16 or 15, correct? 15, 14, 13, 12, sorry, 12, 11, 10, then 9, 8. Then I put a dot over here, okay? Then 7th bit, 6th, 5th, 4th, 3rd, 2nd, 1st, 0, correct? Okay, guys, now that 2 raised to 0 concept, 2 raised to 0, what it is? 2 raised to 0 is 1. Then 2 raised to 1, the same, guys, you know, like class C, it is 2. Then 2 raised to 2, sorry, I missed it somewhere. 2 raised to, oh, sorry. 2 raised to 2, it will be 4, then 2 raised to 3, 8, then 2 raised to 3, I hope I have done, it's done, 4, it's 16, then 2 raised to 5, it is what, 32, and 2 raised to 6, 64, very good. Then 2 raised to 7, guys, we know it's 128, right? Then a dot which I'm keeping over here, so it's differentiated between your 2 and 3rd and 4th octet, correct? Okay, guys, then now 2 raised to 8, 256, give it. Then 2 raised to 9, 1024. 2 raised to 9, how much? 512. Then 2 raised to 10, 1024. Then 2 raised to 11, 2048. Then 2 raised to 12. Oh, I didn't miss it, you know, guys. I just keep it, I do it afterwards. I just went one row below actually. It's 4096. And 2 raised to 13, 8192. And 2 raised to 14, how much? 16384. Okay. And 2 raised to 15, that is 32768. That's it. I just went 2 rows below actually, I just copied and pasted on the above row. We'll see, cut it and put it over here. Okay, now I just put them in a proper way. In that Tableau format. Okay, guys, so this is the 3rd octet I just put here for your information. 3rd octet. This is my octet, correct? So guys, now class B, lots of fun, correct? So many bits to play with, total 16 bits. Okay, now guys, what are these values? What are these? Yeah. Now see guys, if I I'll do one thing. Every bit has got a bit number, correct? Yeah. See, if I talk for then the single bit, this is 1, correct? 1, 2, 4, 8, like this. I'll do one thing. I will cut this table from here. Okay, I put that values above. Over here. This is what 1. Okay, this is 128. Correct? The bit value, guys. Okay? 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 211, correct? Yeah? Same way, here also I talk about this bit value is what? You see, there are integer 8 bits, correct? This is 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1, correct? And I'll put a dot over here also. These are the bit values, correct? Every bit has a value. But when I take a power from here to here, what I got? This is what, nothing, you know what is my? This is my host portion, host. This is the number of host, okay? Then what guys next? Subnet mask, correct? Okay? Now subnet mask, you know guys, what it is? 128 first bit. Adding next, what do you get? 192. Now you add this one, correct? You can't add this. These are our host portion, correct? But every bit has got bit values, correct? That will be what, 224. This is going to be same, correct guys? 240 and 248. Then 252, 254, and 255, correct? Dot. Now guys, over here what will be the net mask for the next values? Will it be increasing or will it be starting out from 128? You see, all bit 1s is 255. The next octet again starts from 128, correct? Okay. Remember class A 255.000. Class B 255.255.00. This will be 255, it can be dot 128. Let's see the as per the requirements. This will be again what? 192, 224, 240, 248, 252, 254, and 255, correct? Understood guys? This is your subnet mask. Now here number of subnets, correct? How much you will get? Now remember guys, in class B, I write over here. Okay, right over here below this time now. Okay, I'll do one thing. I put some rows over there. Okay, in class B, guys, do we say? I put one more row. Class B, one bungalow. This is one network. How much host I get? 65536, correct? But we have broken into two networks. Two networks, how many I get?
8 to 7, 6, 8.
Very good. How you got it? And this is divided by 2, correct? So same way guys, if I divide this 6 by 5 by 6 with these host values, what I get over here? 2? 4? Correct? And as I do remember guys, in class B also, that time we had only one single octet. Start from here 2 to somewhere over here, correct? I start from 2 over here and go till end over here, correct? So 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, got it guys?
Yes.
Keep on increasing, then 512, 1024, then with what next? 2048, 4096, 8192, 16384, 32768, and what was the last? 65536. That's it. Correct? So this is what your wise. This is your subnet portion. Correct? Now see guys, again, as the subnets are increasing, hosts are decreasing. See, if I make 2 bungalows, how many hosts I'll get? 32768. If I make 2048 bungalows, each bungalow how many hosts? 32 hosts. Correct? If I make 64,000 bungalows, I get only one room, correct? Yeah, same panda. Correct guys, only table is bigger and the values are bigger, okay? Now if you do subnetting here also again, the same table you are having. Let's play with it. Okay. Okay guys, I will write in the same panda. If I borrow 2 bits, I'll get 4 bungalows, this many host and this is your net mask, correct? If I borrow 8 beads, 8 beads means how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 beads. I get 256 bungalows, each having 256 rooms. And what are the networks? .255. Correct? And it will be .0. Okay? Understanding? So I write it for you because it's very helpful for you, this table. So bits to be borrowed, correct? Bits borrow, correct? Then next, what you are, how many subnets you will get, correct? How many hosts you will get? How many subnets you will get? What will be the subnet mask, correct? Okay, if I borrow 1 bit, how many hosts you will get? 32768. Subnets will get 2 subnets. Subnet mask will be what? 255. Now see, it's class B. The default net mask is what? 255.255.0.0. Again, you know why subnetting is what? Borrowing bits from host portion to network portion, correct? Remember, this is network, correct? This is network and network. See, I wrote NN, then third and fourth octet. So, net mask will be what? 255.255.128.0. Okay? Understanding, guys? End mask. Okay, how to play with. So first bit is what? 1 minute. And then I'm not using last octave, so it will be not 0. If I borrow 2 bits, how many hosts shall I get? 16384. Subnets. Net mask. 255.255.190.0. Got it? If I borrow 3 bits, what is the net mask? What is the number of hosts shall I get? 8192. Okay, number of subnets 8, and net mask will be for them will be how much? 224.0, correct? Okay, if I borrow 4 bits, I do one thing, I just write here 4, 3, 4, up to how much you can go, guys? Up to 14, correct? Yeah, as you know, if I borrow 15 bits till here, I'm going to get nothing, correct? We go to the, see, maximum if I borrow 15 bits, I get two rooms. Then no use, correct? Okay. If I borrow 4 bits, what I'll get? 2048, correct? Host 16 bungalows. Net mass will be 255.240.0, correct? Yeah, this is 4096, my mistake. Okay. If I borrow 5 bits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is the 2048 is the host? You get how many? 32 bungalows, and the advance will be 255.255.248.0, correct? If I borrow 6 bits, number of rooms will be 1024. What is the net mass? What is the number of bungalows? 64. Net mass will be 255.255.252.0. If I borrow 7 bits, how many bungalows you'll get and how many rooms you'll get? You get 512 rooms, correct? Yes. Number of bungalows will be 128. Net mass will be 255.255.254.0. Okay? Yes. And if I borrow 8 bits, how many bungalows you get? Rooms you get 256, correct? We get 256 bungalows and each bungalow will have 256 hosts. And what is the net mass? 255. You are borrowing all 8 bits, correct? Yes. Round up to 255.0. Now I'm going further. Okay, now see, guys. Hosts are increasing, the subnets are decreasing, correct? Sorry, hosts are decreasing, number of bungalows are increasing, correct? Now, if I borrow 8, 9 bits, how many hosts shall I get? Are you at 128 hosts? Okay, bungalows, 512 bungalows. Now, net mass will be what? 255.255.255.128. Got it, guys? Okay, then, if I borrow 10 bits, how much you will get? So, see, this 8 bits, 9. 10. So how many bungalows I get? 1024, and I get 64 rooms in every bungalow, correct? Okay, 1024. Net mass will be 255.255.192. Then same way, I get 32 rooms if I borrow 11 bits. Number of bungalows will be 2048.255.255.224, correct? Then if I borrow what? 12 bits, how many rooms I get? How many bungalows I get? Rooms I get 16. Bungalows will be 4096. And net mass will be for them will be 255.255.255.240. sorry. And if I borrow 13 bits, I'll get 8 rooms. I'll get 8192 bungalows. And advance will be 255.255.255.248. And if I borrow 14 bits, max I can get 4 rooms. Bungalows will be 16384. And advance will be 255.255.255.252. That's it. Because guys, maximum I can borrow 14 bits with class B, correct? And after that, if I go to 15 bit, my number of rooms are less, which does not satisfy any value, correct? So understood guys how I got this. See, number of hosts are increasing, bungalows are decreasing, correct? Okay, I'll not say this file, I just say this file first. This is your class B subnetting, okay? I show you the same location. Subnetting. Class B. Okay? Now, let's do some examples, correct? First example. Sorry. I have a network of 150.100.0.0. By default is netmask. Default will be 255.0.0, correct? Okay. First example, I have a requirement of, if I take a bigger value, 8000 host. Okay. So guys, 8000 host, so we have to see the host column. For that again, how much should be a bit borrow, correct? Bits to be borrowed. Then how much host you will get, how much subnets you will get, and what will be the subnet mask, correct? Okay. So let's guys see the table. 8000 host. Host to 8000, yeah, yes, yes. If I go further, so I should borrow first 3 bits, correct? If I go to 4 bit, it is getting decreasing. So I think I should borrow 4 bits. Number of bits borrow how much? 3.
Number of bits?
Borrowed. 1, 2, 3, no?
Okay.
From host towards network. See, network, see, you go always start from this, close one, correct? Okay. Number of bits, 1, 2, 3. Okay, how many host I will get? See here. 8192. Okay. 8192. Subnets will be how much? 8 subnets, correct? I get 8 bungalows, each having 8000 rooms, and netmask will be what? It is 224, correct?
Yes.
See the value over there?
Yes.
224, correct? Can you see?
Yes.
Sushil?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so 8 bungalows. If I borrow 3 bits, if I want 8000 hosts, this is my bit number, correct? Bit number 3. So I will get 8 bungalows, each having 8000 rooms, and netmask will be 224, got it? Okay, so 255.255.224.0, correct? Because I am doing my subnetting. Guys, why is the subnetting happening? Why is the requirement is in your third octet, correct? Your requirement is getting satisfied in your third octet.
Yes.
The fourth octet you are using entirely, correct? Inside your host bits. Okay. So now if I write the structure again over here, remember guys, the network ID, correct? Then I am taking a gap over here now. First valid IP, then my last valid IP and my podcast IP. Okay. Now guys, let me open my rough pad for this first. I'm talking about a class C, okay? Class B, sorry. Number of hosts, how much guys? 8192. Subnets, how much? 8. Correct? Netmask is what? 255.224.0, correct? Now guys, what is the network ID? It is 150.100.0.0, correct? Now see guys, one bono is having 8000 rooms, correct? So when I start writing the block size, how will I write it? 150.100.0.0, then 150.100.0.1, then 150.100.0.2, then 150. dot 100 dot 0 dot 3. That is up to you to go to how much, guys? 150 dot 100 dot 0 dot 255. 255. Okay. Now it will be 150 dot 100 dot 1 dot 0. Correct. And it will be 150 dot 100 dot 2 dot 1 dot 1. Correct. Now it will be 150 dot 100 dot 1 dot 2. That is it to go up to 150 dot 100 dot 1 dot 255. That will be 150 dot 100 dot 2 dot 0. But like, guys, why should I wait? Why should I stop, correct? I didn't got that value, correct? How to stop? Now come back to the table and see the magic. Okay, I will get 8,000 rooms, correct? I'm going to get 8 bungalows, 8 blocks, correct? Idea blocks also. Okay, so I'm going to get 8 blocks. 1, 2, I'm going to get how much? 8 blocks, correct? 8 blocks. I'm going to start with 150.100.0. Where is this guy going to end, correct? See, the block size I got is 8192. Should I keep on going like this in my notepad, like, correct, up to 8000? No. Now guys, just see the hint over here, very important, just pay attention. See your table. 8190 is over here, correct? This bit number 3, correct? What is the bit value? This will be the, my breakup for the first block. This bit number is going to help me with the breakup. How? Just see here. Where is my notepad? Like this, it will go up to how much? This way, it will go up to 150.100.31.0. Up to 150.100.31.255. Here my first block ends the idea, guys. See, subnetting is in third octet, correct? Subnetting is happening in third octet. And what is the, we saw these values, correct? Subnet mask and the host. What is the bit value? Bit of this 32? This will help me to break my first block. Okay. So my first block is broke where, guys? Over here. From 0 to 31, correct? My next block will start at what? 150.100.32.0. At 32. 150.100.63.255. This will be the end of my second block. Okay. But now guys, let's expand this. The bitting part, correct? If I expand this, it will go to how much? 150.100.32.1. And 150.100.32.2 up to 150.100.32.55. That will be 150.100.33.0. That will be 150.100.33.1, like this up to 150.100.33.255. That will be 150.100.34.0. Guys, I'm tired. This way you go for 32, 33, 34 up to, I put the last value now, 150.100.62.0, correct? That will be 150.100.62.1. Then it will be 150.100.62.255, correct? Correct. That will be 150.100.63.1. Correct. Sorry, not 1. It will be 0. Okay. Okay. Then it will be, guys, 150.100.63.1. Correct. Like this. It will go until this one. So this is my second block, guys. Guys, but to write in shortcut, what is 32 to? See, is the summary is in third octet, correct? So from 32 to 63, correct? See the first block, it started from 0 up to 31. And 32 to 63. Now let's write the further blocks, guys. 150.100. It will start at 64, correct? Now just, guys, keep on adding 32. 150.100.64 plus 32, how much? 96? Correct? 96.0? So if I go one step ahead, this block will end at 150.100.95.255, correct? This will be the end of my third block, correct? Understanding? Okay. So let's write down in the Excel file now, guys. But I just open the entire block, guys. This, you know, from 30.0 to 63.255, this total, you know, this entire total comes to almost 8192 host. You see your requirement, guys. It is 8192, correct? 8000 hosts. So we are getting 8192 hosts, correct? How to cross check? See, guys, simple. For 32, you are going to get a value from 32.0 to 255, correct? 256, yeah. For 33 also, you are going to get 256 values, correct? 0 to 256, 32 to 255. For 34 also, you are going to get 256 values, correct? Open your CALC. CALC. 256 into 32, correct? We are going to get 32 times that value. Oh, sorry. Why is it cancelled? 32 into 256. How much you get? 8192. This is what your number of hosts you are going to get over here, correct, guys? Understanding? So, how to play the trick? The bit value. You see, guys, I am going to get same way 6000 host, but where will my bit get broke? Where my first block will get end, correct? So bit value defines your that part, okay? In that range you will get so many hosts. So this will start with 50.150.100.0.1 will start, correct? What will be the last red IP? Yeah, guys, see, broadcast, if I keep it over here, okay, let me write the next one directly. 150.100.32.0, correct? And this will end at what? This will end at 150.100.31.255. The last word IP is what? 150.100.31.254. Alright? Middle part is on your notepad. Alright? You can go this, when you go home, you can just check this. How I played over here. Okay, I just put here class B also, the heading. It's a rough part, guys, but it's very helpful. Okay, guys, all the rough work we do out over here. Also, say this file also. Subnetting rough work. Okay. Understanding, guys, how we go with this. The first example, I know it take quite heavy on you, but you understood the concept. First, we saw the bit value, correct? Number of bits we borrowed. Our requirement 8000 host, subnet mask, and we got the number of subnets. But where to break the first bungalow, correct? I am going to get 8000 rooms, but where it will break? As per the bit value. The third octet, it will break at over here. Same way, I just put everything over here now. 100.32+32 almost 64, correct? Yeah, you just keep on adding. 150.100.64+ that one is how much? 96. That will be 150.100.128, correct, guys? Yes. Keep on in 32 and 150.100.160, I hope so. Then 150.100.192, correct? 2.0 and 150.100.224.0, correct? I just added last values now over here. For this one, it will already be 150.100.63.255, correct? This will be 150.100.95, correct? But see, one value above, one value more than this, correct? Minus this, one value above this. So 95.255, then 150.100.127.255, and 159.255, then 150.100.191.255, and the last one will be what? Ending part 100.255.255. Got it? And middle values, now you can guess it, what it is, guys?
Second.
Oh, sorry, my mistake. 150.100.223. This is 223. 255, and this will be 150.100.255.255. Okay, how to understand, guys, how to make it simple? Play with the bit values. See, Over here, no problem. What is the bit value? The same as the number of hosts, correct? But when I come in second or third octet, see now, if I get 4,000 hosts, what is bit value is going to be 16. So breakout will be after 16 bits. It's not 16 bits, I'll say 16, that number. Okay? The first example, understood? We'll do some more examples, okay? Okay, guys, next I'll do the second example. My requirement is of 1,000 host. Okay. Now, again, the bits borrow. Then your number of hosts that you'll get, number of subnets you'll get, and then your subnet mask. Correct. So, guys, 1,000 host. Let me know. You tell me, guys. The table is in front of you. How many bits should I borrow for 1,000 host? How many bits? Six bits? See. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 bits. How many bungalows are you get? 64 bungalows. And each bungalow will have how many hosts? 1024. Okay, bit value will come to later part. Okay. So, let me write down the first basic things. 6 bits I should borrow. Number of hosts I will get? 1024. Number of subnets will be? 64. Net mask will be what? Oh, sorry. 255 255 255 2.0, correct? You see, guys, I'm not still using the fourth octet. I'm still using this entire octet over here, correct? 252. Got it? Okay. Now, if I write this in the same format, the block concept, I just copy it from here. So, guys, first network is what? 150.100.0.0, correct? Now, where this will end? You see, I'm not going to write all the 64 bungalows here. I write the first 4 and the last 4, okay? So guys, ending part, what will be? Now see guys, I will get 1024 hosts, correct? What's the bit value? 4. Let's take my scratch pad. Okay, this example will end over here. Now, again, I wrote here the concept, now. Yeah. How many hosts I want? 1024, correct? And subnets will be how much? 64. And subnet mask is what? 255 255 252.0, correct? Okay, when I start writing, guys, 150.100.0.0 150.100.0.1, like this, you would how much? 150.100.0.255, correct? That will be 150.100.1.0. So now, guys, the bit value, remember, we are bringing third octet. What's the bit value? 4. This will end, you know where, guys? Now, you know, guys, how is going further? 150.100.3.255. That's it. This is where your first bungalow ends. Correct? So if you open this entirely, see, with 0, you are going to get. I just will expand this for one for your exam understanding. 150.100.1.1. Then this will be 150.100.1.255. Sorry. Correct? Then it will be what? 150.100.2.0. Then it will be 150.100.2.1. Then it will be 150.100.2.255. Correct? Then it will be 150.100.3.0. Then it will be 150.100.3.1. Sorry. Correct? Like this, guys, 1024 hosts. Yes, see, guys, with 0, you are going to get 0255 is how much? 256. With 1 also 256, 2 also 256, and 3 also 256. So, again, guys, open the calculator. 256 into 4 is how much? 1024, correct, guys? So, your requirement is correct. Okay, then my next bungalow will be what? 150.100.4.0, correct? Why this will end directly? I just put end value. 7.255, correct now? Understanding the second bungalow, third bungalow 8.0. See, guys, every bungalow starts with the even number, ends with the odd number, correct? If you see the previous example also, see, every bungalow starts with the even number. Can you see the starting ending with the odd number, correct? Okay, so keep on adding 4 like this. What I get? 150.100.11.255. And let's go to end part, guys. 150.100. This end at 255, correct? Everyone ends at 255. So if I write the starting of this one, it should be how much? 252.0, correct? Yeah, guys. Correct. And if I go one step like this, 251.255, 150.100.248. Correct. Easy, simple. So guys, understanding us? How it goes? How the things play over here? So your bit number defines the breakup. Correct. 4444 like this. Correct. So same way, guys. If I write this example in my Excel file now. Okay, let's write down our Excel file. And we'll not write all the 64 subnets. You see, guys, 64 subnets will take a huge time. We write the first block of this one, second block of this one. Then we write the block number 63 and 64. Correct. Sorry. Correct. So, if I start writing here, okay, this is the first block actually. The second block and this is the third block. Okay, first byte IP 150.100.0.1. Correct. Okay, I write the last value, which is what? 150.100.3.255. Correct. As per your bit value. So 150.100.0. Sorry, it's 3.254. Correct. Last byte IP. See the here also. First block 254 will be the last byte IP. Correct. Okay. Excel file. Okay. Now guys, the next will be 150.100.4.0. Correct. Now next will be 8.0. Correct. It's an addition of 444. Correct. Right over here, the broadcast also now 100.7.255. Same way here, what will be 150.100.11.255. Correct. Now the last two are adding. I'm writing last part, guys. Last two blocks. 100.252. Correct. This will go up to how much? 252. Oh yeah, my mistake. 252. What will be over here, guys? 150.100. Yeah. Yes.
2.
No. This is actually you know I wanted it. I just go away. This would be actually you know. 150.100.248.0. Okay, and this will be 150.100.252.0. Correct. And this will be ending will be what? End part will be .100.255.255. Correct. And this will be 150.100.251.255. Got it, guys? So we have like this, we get 64 subnets, and the middle part you know now very well. Okay. So understanding, guys, subnetting, yes. Class B also. Yes, you should know how to write it down. Okay, you should write the blocks. Okay, exam what it comes, I'll tell you later. First we complete all the subnetting part, we complete a VLSM part. Then we play the exam topic examples. Okay, in exam they will not tell you to do all these things. It is a different concept. I'll teach you after that. Okay, but first understand how to do subnetting. So this what you are doing is what, guys? If it's FLSM, correct? Fixed length subnet mask. Okay, so any queries still here? Okay. We'll take one more example of class B. Now see, we talk about 8000 hosts, 1000 hosts, correct? Okay. Now guys, we'll play in the 4th octet. Okay, we'll play in the 4th octet. I want 4000 bungalows. I want 4000 bungalows. So I go with the 3rd example. I have a requirement of 4000 subnets, correct? Now again, the bits to be borrowed. Then your host you will get, how much subnets you will get, and how much will be a subnet mask, correct? So now guys, you tell me, if I want to borrow 4000 host, how many bits should I borrow?
16 bits.
Are you sure? Don't see the bit value, see the number.
Four.
No wrong.
Four,
see, we
four.
Borrow bits from this side. We go from this end, correct? We go from network towards host, na?
See,
social, we are going from this side. We borrow 1 bit, 2 bit, 3 bit, 4 bits. We borrow this manner. So, first, second, third. Okay, we are having subnets, correct?
Okay.
First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. All 8 bits done. Not over here. Let's go to the next. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, got it? We are going from this way. Always go from this manner. So, we are going host to network, na?
Yes.
Sorry. So, if I borrow 12 bits, I will get 16 rooms in every host, every bungalow, correct? I get 4000 bungalows. and with every bone having 16 rooms, correct? And see now here b2 value is not a concern because why? It's same value, correct?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. Now guys, let me write down the bits and everything. Bit borrows how much? Pure bits. Yeah. Number of hosts you'll get how much? 4096. Yeah. Number of subnets will be 16. Net mask will be what now guys? 255.255. Because see, I am using all these 8 bits, correct?
Yes.
This 255 completed. Then my next, this 4 bits. It's what? 240. Correct? So, it will be dot 240. Got it? Understanding guys? Now let's write this in this manner again. First you write down our scratch pad. Okay? Let me put it over here. Okay? Let's take a scratch pad. So, next example, oh sorry. This example end over here. We go to our next example. How many hosts I want? 16 hosts, correct? How many subnets I'm going to get? 4096. What is going to be the subnet mask? 255.240. Okay. So 150.100.0.0. Correct? Now what is the range guys? 16. The range is of 16. The blocks are 16. This is good how much? And what is subnetting happening? The subnetting is happening where now in the 4th octet, correct guys? Subnetting is taking place in the 4th octet. Correct? Okay. So it will be 100.0.1. It will be 150.100.0. up to 15, correct? This is my first bungalow having 16 hosts, correct? And now next bungalow 0.16, correct? Where this will end? Where dot 0.31, correct? Like this 150 100 dot 0.32, where this will end? How much tell me guys? 16 47, okay? Because 48 is the next one, correct? So like this, guys, you know, I'm going to get 4,000 rooms, subnets, correct? I'm going to get, guys, 4,000 bungalows. Now, where it will go, correct? Now, see, guys, this is going to go to how much, you know? 150.100.224.0, correct? Sorry, 0.224 up to 150.100.0.239. This will be end of my this bungalow. Then I will come to 150.100.0.240, and this will end at 150.100.0.255. Correct? But is my bungalow over? No. Now I will start from 100.1.0. Okay, see, with 0 to 15, 0 to 16, 31, 30 to 47, 48, like this up to 224, 229, 240, 255. Then over here again the same procedure with 1.0. See what I did with zeros, that will be with 1. And now this will be ending at where? 150.100.1.15, correct? Then it will be 150.100.1.16. That will be 150.100.1.31. Understanding guys, this will go to how much? 150.100.1.240, 150.100.1.255, correct? Then it will be 150.100.2.0, understanding? But like this, then it will be 150.100.3.0, 4.0, up to how much guys? Let's come to end now. It will be 255.0. That will be 150.100.255.15. Okay. Then it will be 150.100.255.16. It will be 150.100.255.31. Correct. Then it will be ending where? 150.100.255.240. The last octet actually. 150.100.255.255. Ah. I am tired guys. So huge. Because how many subnets I am going to get guys? I am going to get 4,000 bungalows. Writing 4,000 bungalows? Yes, we can write down, but it is an entire day for you to write, correct? It's not impossible, you can write it. Okay, but you have to do lots of practice, correct? Understanding, guys? So, this one bungalow, second bungalow, third one, right? I'm going to get guys two, how much four and six bungalows? How to cross check again? See, with zero, how many bungalows you are going to get, guys? With zero, how much? Like this, 16, 16, 16, how much? With zero, how much you are going to get? With zero, how much you are going to get like this? See, 16 into 16, 256, correct? So you're going to get 16 bungalows with 0, correct? And that is how much it is? Total 256. From 0 to 255, right? It's 256. So again, go to your calculator. 256 into 16. 4096. 4096 bungalows you're going to get. Okay. Okay, now let's write down over here. Now I'm not going to write all the blocks, okay? I'm going to first block, second block, third block. Then I'll write the block number which? 4095, and write a block number 4096. Understanding? Okay, the first block 150.100.0.0 150.100.0.1. I did a mistake. Wrong block, value actually, wrong place. 150.100.0.1, correct? Okay, what is the last one over here? 150.100.0.15, correct? And this should be what? 150.100.0.14. Then next one will be 150.100.0.16, correct? Which, what will end over here? 150.100.0.31, correct? That is just like the last two values, guys. 150.100.255.240. Correct? This will be 150.100.255.255, correct? Take one more up. 150.100.255.224, correct? Sorry, mistake. 224, correct? This is a range of 16. So what is the end here? End over 255.239. Guys, you understood this part? Of course, very lengthy actually, but you should know how to do it. What? So this table is a god for us, correct? Any marks, any bit. So for let's say some oral examples, orally. If I borrow 10 bits, how many hosts I'll get and how many bungalows I'll get? 10 bits, so see again, Sushil, always borrow bits from this way. Always go from this way, no? Don't come from that way, it's the wrong way, okay? 10 bits means, of course, first 8 I'm going to use everything. 8, 9th and 10th bit. So I'm going to get how many, guys? I'm going to get 1000 rooms, that is 1024 bungalows. And each bungalow will have 64 rooms, correct? Understanding? And the way to write down now, you know very well, I've shown the scratch pad. How to open up and write it, correct? Understanding, guys? Okay, this example is got over here. I just put a marker over here. Okay. So then, if I want 500 host. How many bits should I borrow? 500 host. So see as host row, correct? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, I think 7 is 7th bit is getting my requirement satisfied, correct? 7th bit, 512 host. I'll get 128 bungalows. Each should have 512 rooms. And see the bit value is what? 2. So guys, do one more example of this also. The bit value. Because see guys, this is very simple. 16, 16, 8, 120, you can do it. But when it comes to the third octet, you know guys, I told you over here. If I'm doing an example of third octet, this is a bit pattern, correct? Where should the start and end bit, correct? Okay. So do one thing, we'll do one more example where we are playing with this 512 host, correct? Okay. So your concept will get more clear to you. Okay, the last example for today for class B. Okay. Fourth example, I think. This is the fourth example. My requirement is how much, guys? 500 host. That's it. Okay. The bits borrow. Then what? Your how much host you'll get? Subnets and your subnet mask, correct? Okay, okay. It's over here. That's what I'm saying. I already did this before. We'll see. It's control V, na? Cut, copy, paste. Sorry. video here. That copy bits. Okay. So as bits borrow, now let me know how many bits should I borrow, correct? Okay. So how many bits I borrow for 500 host? 7 bits, correct? Number of hosts I'm going to get how much? 512. Number of subnets I'm going to get how much, guys? How many subnets there are actually? See, 7 bits. So how many actually remaining with? 2 raised to 9, how much? 128, correct? Yeah, sorry, subnets, 128 subnets, correct? And number of hosts is around how much? 7 bits are 2 raised to 7 is 128, and 2 raised to 9 is 512, correct? The number of your subnets, how much? 128, and your net mask, guys, 255 dot 7 bits is how much? It's 254, correct? Bit 7 bit is how much? It is 254, correct? Okay. Is going to be 254.0. Okay. Again, the writing part, guys. So, okay, I just take this from you. See, copy. Okay, let's write in the first scratch pad. Now, I see the bit value. What was the bit value to how much? 2, correct? Okay, 512 host and bit value is 2. Guys, before starting my this concept, let me show you my notepad. Okay, where were we? Okay, so guys, number of hosts is how much? 512. Number of subnets is how much? 128 subnets, correct? And subnet mask is 255.254.0, correct? When I start writing, guys, it will be something like this: 150.100.0.0. 150.100.0.1. This is good. How much? 150.100.0.255. Correct. That will be 150.100.1.0. Correct. This will go to how much? 1.1. Then up to 3.100.1. Now that is a bit value. Bit value is of 2. Correct. 0 to 1. That's it. This is the first bungalow. Got it? Okay, because I'm going one, because I'm going to have 128 bungalows, correct? Okay, guys, so see, 0 to 255, it is 256, correct? Divided by 2, 128. So see, 2 over here, 0 and 1 over here. Now next block, 150.2.0 and 150.100. This will be 2.1. Where this will end, guys? 150.100.3.255, correct? Okay, so guys, this is the first, second block, I hope. Then our next block will be what? 150.100.4.0. These are the end value. If I add the end value, what will it be? 100.5.255, correct?
Yes.
This is a block, if the bit value is of 2, correct? Yeah, guys. So block limit is of 2 bits, correct? Or 2 values. Let's go to end of the part. 100.255. It will end at 255, correct? But if I go up, this will be starting somewhere at 150.100. Where, guys? 254.0. Correct? Understanding?
Yes.
Let's take one more value up. This will be what? 150.100.253. Correct? .255. Oh, sorry. We are going up actually. 150.100.252.0. Correct, guys? Understood? Let's start in the Excel file now, guys. So I'm not going to write all the 120 blocks. I write the first block, second block, and then I write block number 127, block number 128. Okay. So 150.100.0.0. First value IP will be, all of you know now, guys, very well now, 0.1. Okay. Where this end actually? 150.100.2.255. Correct. And last value IP will be 150.100.2.254, correct? Then 150 or 100 dot, what is the next? Sorry, my mistake over here, guys. You know what? This will be 1 over here, correct? See, every block ends with a odd number, correct? So it will be 1 actually, because the range of 2, correct? See, guys, and this will be 2.0. Fully mistaken. 100.2.0, correct? 2.0, correct? What will be the end over here? 150 100 dot 3.255, correct? Now this will be then 2, then what will be 4, 6, like that up to, let's see the last two topics, last two parts. 3.100 dot, this will be what? 254.0, correct? Yeah, guys. And this will be 150.100 dot 252.0, correct? Okay, where this guys will end? The second last one, 150.100 dot 253 dot 255. And this guy will end where? 150.100 dot 255 dot 255. That's it. So, understood guys how to play with subnetting, how to write this block size, block limits. The thing is what you should understand this table. This table gives you all the examples, correct? You get everything over here in the table. So guys, that's it for today for class B subnetting. How to play with this octet. See, if you are playing third octet, for the breakup just see the bit value, correct? And just put a bit value range. If you are playing with fourth octet, no need to worry. Same thing is going to go. See, in fourth octet, the number of bungalows will be more. See, can you see? 1000, 4000, 8000 bungalows. Can you see guys? Again, in class B, how much can I do subnetting? Up to 14 bits, correct? I can borrow maximum 14 bits. If I borrow all 16, I'll get what a big value. That is what this value, correct? If I want 50,000 host, use the entire network, correct? But if I want less than 32,000 networks, I can play with them. Okay, I can play with the bit borrowers pattern. So, any issues to you guys? Any queries? Okay. So, this is understood to you. Okay. So, now, tomorrow we'll begin with the class A part. Okay.